Newsmax.com, also Newsmax TV. Really glad to have you for the ride. I always love having Ted Poe on. He's a U.S. representative from the great state of Texas. Ted, how are you?
I'm doing great, Joe. Thanks.
All right, so I get this word yesterday, and I appreciate you guys giving me the heads up before it went out widely, that that you've decided you're not going to run for re-election. And as you know, I sat down across from the president last week, and in the minutes I was given, he also told me Ted Poe is never allowed to leave. So you're going to have to change those plans, my man.
Well, thank you, Joe, but it's time to go back to Texas after 14 years in Congress, and being a congressman is not a career for me.
Yeah.
When I got elected, my four kids were single, and now they're all married and I have 12 grandkids.
Oh, man.
And so it's time to get back to Texas on a permanent basis, but I'll be very active and I'll have plenty to do, even in the political realm back in Texas.
Well, I think that was my next question. Are you going to stay politically active? Are you going to push for who gets the seat next? Or are you going to help, you know, maybe help people primary some rhinos out and get some more conservative people in? What's the plan?
I'm here for 14 months working on issues that are important to us, human trafficking, right of privacy. Then after that, I'll be politically active in helping people behind the scenes. So that's what the plan is right now.
Congressman Ted Poe, great Republican from the great state of Texas. So, I mean, you're not like retiring or something today. You're going to serve out your term, just not running for re-election.
That is correct.
All right. Let's talk about some of what's going on right now. The media is going nuts about something that happened in Texas on Sunday. In fact, I have it on good word because it's only about 25 miles from where I'm sitting, that Sutherland Springs is done with the media because they've been kind of rude and kind of running roughshod over the town. But today, as we speak, Vice President Pence is there. You've got Ted Cruz is there and John Cornyn, our two senators. You've got Henry Cuellar. We've got, I think, the Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, is there. We had this horrific thing happen in a House of Our Lord on Sunday, and immediately the left made it political, made it about a ban this and ban that, and the Second Amendment should go. When you first heard about it, what was your knee-jerk reaction? And now that we've had a couple of days to think about it, what would you like to say to people who are watching across the nation about us here in Texas and how we're handling this?
Well, first of all, I can think of nothing worse than someone going into the house of the Lord on a Sunday morning where people are worshiping and committing murder by any means. Nothing worse. And I think that the way the people in Sutherland Springs and Texans have really gotten together of support for those families that have had that tragedy happen to them is impressive. But that's the way we do things in Texas.
It's true.
As far as the left goes, got to remember the goal of the left is always control of personal liberty of the rest of us. Every piece of legislation they sponsor is about control, controlling our personal lives. And this is another example where they're going to use a tragedy for political purposes, although there were laws in place that could have prevented this, the laws that were not followed, laws that were not enforced. They don't care. It's all about taking the guns away from Americans. So that's their agenda, and they will use any means to do that and any opportunity, and that's unfortunate. We've got to remember, of course, that the killer was chased down by someone that had a firearm.
Right.
And those guys, God bless them, they went after him, and they weren't taking no for an answer until they actually wounded him and took him down. So it took a firearm to take down somebody that's using a firearm. That's what happens. That's what happened in this case. And we will fix the problem with the Air Force and other agencies who fail to report what they should report of people who shouldn't get guns.
Well, I mean, how does that happen? And Ted, everything you said, I agree with. The good guy with a gun grabbed his rifle, shot this guy twice, probably mitigated what he was going to do next because he didn't find his mother-in-law in that church. So maybe he was on the lookout. Maybe he was going to go 2 miles up the road. The next church was there. Maybe he was going to go there next. So, and he had all sorts of ammunition and rounds or whatever. So this guy stopped him. I believe he stopped him. This guy felt cornered, so he ends up shooting himself in the head. Having said all of that, the media is here. And I don't know if you've watched any of the coverage. The media actually said, and I've seen this question asked many, many times of the residents of this town that many of us have never even heard of, and it's pretty close by. They've asked this question: do you think prayer is enough? You know, it blows my mind that they would dare go there and ask a question that's questioning the faith of people in that town who obviously are turning to their Lord in this time of mourning. When you hear something like that, does it make your skin crawl like it does mine?
It shows that the media is totally out of touch with the real world and the way people are, especially in Texas, who have faith, who are people of faith, and they turn to the Lord when tragedy happens, just like they turn to the Lord when good things happen. And you know, that's what the people do, and that's what they're doing in Sutherland Springs. And I can see why they are fed up with a bunch of outsiders coming in and telling them how to mourn for the loss.
It's Congressman Ted Poe. We love having you on. Academy sold this guy at least two of the guns, not their fault, because his background was not put in the federal database. This guy had beaten up his wife, had fractured the skull of his stepbaby. He had been put in a mental institution, escaped the mental institution, was found again. He was put in the mental institution because he was caught trying to bring firearms on base to kill his chain of command. How this guy doesn't, I mean, this guy is a poster child for can't get a gun. Ted, how do you think that happened, and what do we do to stop it?
Well, it happened. There were probably several breakdowns, but the one that we know about the most is once he was convicted of abuse, where he cracked the skull of an 18-month-old baby. First of all, 1 year for that. If I'd have been the judge, it would have been 98 more years besides that at 1 year.
I wish
you'd
have been the judge, yeah.
Judges would have done the same thing, but they gave him a year and then let him go, and that some airman on base should have put into the data FBI system that he was convicted of domestic violence, and that would have kept him from getting a gun. And he would have failed the background check by anybody who had gone into that database, and somebody didn't do it. It was a clerical mistake that cost the lives of several people.
I know Cornyn's writing legislation. He's sponsoring a bill that's going to somehow shore this up. If it's already on the books, what can you do to incentivize the Air Force, which is the government, to put it in, or any armed service, or any legitimate, you know, institution that should have put something like this in? How can you make them do it? I mean, from what I've studied in the past 2 days, Ted, it's like rare that anybody's putting stuff in. It's like really, really rare, and they're just not doing their jobs.
Well, I think what you just said is true. The data is not being put into the FBI database, and that's a mistake that has to get stopped, and we have to hold people accountable for failure to do that. And I don't know what Senator Cornyn's legislation is doing. Yeah. Maybe it's have more than one person put the input into the database when this occurs. But the law was in place. It should have been enforced. This would have stopped this particular homicide. And it's a sad situation where the law that we already had didn't need more laws, was not followed.
It's my friend, also Congressman Ted Poe, Republican in the great state of Texas. Ted, you've been a hawk on the border, and you've done an amazing job. You've gone down there several times. We're seeing a drop in illegal border crossings like I don't think anybody even expected. The wall isn't built yet, but we have more surveillance. But what I'm hearing from down there in the area, and what I heard from Cruz last week, was that the people who are working for ICE and the Border Patrol finally feel as though they're allowed to do their jobs. Under the Obama administration, their hands were tied on purpose. Is that what you're hearing too?
Exactly what I'm hearing. The old catch and release policy. What was that? That means that the Border Patrol would capture somebody crossing the border, and if they determined that that person was a first offender, then that person was just taken back to the border and sent back across.
Crazy.
Supposedly. And catch and release, that doesn't exist anymore. Now when you're captured, you're detained and you go to see a magistrate. And so they know that that is happening. When I was down there, people would cross into the United States and hold up their hands so they could get caught and get their card to come back and see a immigration judge in 6 months to a year.
And so nobody would show up either. I mean, nobody would show up when they got that card. They throw it away.
And so what a stupid system that was. So the Border Patrol actually understands now they can do their job. They can capture people and they can put them on the track to get deported back where they came from. If they are brought in the country or captured in the country illegally, they understand that. And that has deterred people from crossing into the United States, that alone. And we are seeing more high-tech stuff put on the border, the balloons that we have in the air.
Oh, yeah.
And the aerostats, that was the phrase I was looking for, aerostats that can see 20 miles in every direction, plus some of the other technology that I just don't want to discuss, but it's actually capturing some of those people that are crossing. So they're doing their job.
As we're speaking, it's 1 year exactly to the day that we had an historic upset in the presidential election. He's been in office now for, what, 10 months, something like that? Give me a grade on President Trump. How do you feel he's doing?
I think he's doing well. Surprisingly, to most people and to the disdain of the left who cannot take it, true. Can't understand it. They're jumping out the windows up here that Trump is president.
Yeah,
he's moving right along. We're getting a lot of things accomplished sort of under the radar. For example, the regulations, the United States' role in the world as the world leader, people looking to us for leadership. As that progresses, there's going to be more stability in the world, not instability. So I think the president, I'd give him a B.
Okay.
On his policy.
Is the uptick in the economy real, Ted?
It is. I get calls from constituents and individual basis and businesses who tell me, hey, you know, things are really good. We are able to invest into our own business again. We can hire people instead of going broke, as they were. And they're looking forward to a tax bill. I think we'll get a tax bill. Question to be asked, is it better than what we have? And the answer, absolutely. So we'll get a tax bill. And I think the president is showing some leadership. He defends himself. And nobody else seems to defend him, but he defends himself, so he will. And some people can quarrel with that, but I would give him a B for his first 10 months.
Yeah, last question. You already hit the taxes. I was going to ask you about that, but I'm with you. I think it'll happen. I do think it's better than things are now. Is it as good as I would like? Probably not, but I think it's better than what we have now. But last question, and again, you're right, he defends himself. But you know what's really telling to me, and I would love for you to comment on this. He goes to Saudi Arabia in the Middle East, and they just kiss his rear end and play trumpets. He goes to Asia, and they're all the pomp and circumstance that you would expect from a president. To me, there's a world of difference between what we called the apology tour, which really was when Barack Obama went on his foreign trips, and how they're treating this president as if he's actually the leader of the free world again. Are you seeing that too, or am I just putting too much into it?
No, you're right. I'm on Foreign Affairs Committee, and I have visited with countries overseas, especially in Eastern Europe. They love President Trump. And, you know, even the left up here was talking about, well, he went to see the Japanese emperor and he didn't bow. Well, of course he isn't going to bow. Man, this is Donald Trump you're talking about.
Right.
The president of the States. Our flag doesn't bow to anybody. So I think his reception and his image and our image, the American image, is better worldwide than it was in the last eight years, especially in the area of leadership.
I got to tell you, I love talking with you. You got to make me a promise. We remain friends when you don't run for re-election, when you serve out your term, and we can still talk about stuff on my show.
Absolutely.
All right, Ted. We love you, and we're so proud to be friends with you. Thank you so much for all the years of you enlightening me, educating my audience, and teaching us, you know, just how great Texans are and how much we love this country. I really do appreciate everything.
That's right. We live in the best place on earth, and more Americans need to appreciate it. Thank you.
Congressman Ted Poe, Republican, the great state of Texas. We'll talk again, sir. We're back after this on the Joe Pags Show. Stay here.